There's a verse. Don't read the full verse. Just read the first line. Tam bhusuta mukti mudarahasam vande yato bhavya bhavam dayashri. Now this is the first half of the verse. Now the second half of the verse is formed by reversing the first half. You start reading from right to left, the same upper line. It forms the second half. Shri Yadavam Bhavya Bhatoya Devam Samharada Mukti Mutasu Bhutam. Now starting from the beginning till the end of the second line, and starting with the end of the second line till the beginning of the first line, it's a palindrome. It reads the same. Now the beauty of this verse is that it is basically one line, the first line. You read it from left to right, the first half of the verse, and read it from the second, the first line from right to left, it becomes the second half of the verse, and then you have a complete verse. But another beauty of this verse is that when you read the same line from left to right, it is about Rama, and the same line when you read from right to left, it is about Krishna. So the two different stories running in the same line from left to right, it is one story, and right to left, it is another story. Tam bhusuta mukti mudarahasam vande yato bhavya bhavam dayashri is giving the description of Sri Rama. The story of Rama, he says, Vande, I adore, I worship Rama who released Sita, the daughter of earth, Bhusuta Muktim, who released Sita, who has a deep smile, beautiful grand smile on his face, Udar Hasam, Yato Bhavya Bhavam Dayasri, so from whom all prosperity, light, splendor, beauty, everything comes from him. This is the meaning of the first half of the verse. When you read it from left to right. And the same line, when you read it from right to left, it is giving the description of Krishna, Sri Yadavam. I bow down before Krishna, who belongs to Yaduvansa, the Yadu dynasty. He was a Yadav. Sri Yadavam, Bhavya Bhatoya Devam, Samharada Mukti Mutasu Bhutam, Asu Bhutam, means he is the very, very soul of this creation, very soul of this universe. And Samharada Mukti, you know the story of Putana, who came to kill Krishna, but ultimately was killed by Krishna. And because she was killed by Krishna, the divine himself, she also became liberated, because she was killed by the divine himself. So one who liberated to Putana, who wanted to kill him, to the killer, to one's own killer, who liberated, Samharada Mukti. So now, you see, this particular verse is taken from a poetry called Ramakrishna Viloma Kavyam. Ramakrishna Viloma Kavyam of Surya Kavi. There are 50 verses in this poem, and each verse, left to right, is about Rama, and right to left is about Krishna. Is it not amazing? Which language? You will find such verses where you find two different stories running in the same line. And also think of the poet. He has to take care of the grammar of the language, the rhythm of the language. How does he think that I place this word, so then from the matrix point of view, from the chandas point of view, the short syllable comes here, long syllable comes here, and the arrangement of syllable by short and long by following this particular meter is happening rightly, the grammar of the language. At the same time, he has to take care of the two stories that he is writing. That you reverse the word, it becomes the story of Krishna, and you write it this way, it becomes the story of Rama. Amazing. Where does one find such examples? And Viloma Kavyam, it's not that Surya Kavi was the one Kavi who composed just one Kavya, Viloma Kavya, Ramakrishna Viloma Kavya. Viloma Kavya is a style of composition, and many poets have used this style of composition to compose many poetry. So you have hundreds and thousands of shlokas, the poems, stanzas, which are composed in this format, Viloma Kavya.